So November is typically one of the months that we always recommend that people deworm their horses in Oklahoma. So at the bare minimum, we always recommend that you do deworm them twice a year. So we kind of use March and November. And then the rest of the time, we're really recommending that people think about doing strategic deworming and actually checking a fecal egg count exam to make sure their horse actually needs to be dewormed again. The reason that we're suggesting that is to try to cut back on essentially resistance to our dewormers, because we really don't have any other products to use. And so we need to think about being a little bit more strategic in our management decisions so that we don't lose the efficacy of those products. Yeah, so it's kind of interesting. So we've moved away from the idea that horses should have zero worms. And we now realize, you know what, it's probably okay. Horses have evolved with worms for a long time. And so some worm burden is probably okay. But we don't want to see really high worm burdens, because that actually can impact the health of the horse. Essentially, the worms are going to be taking a lot of the nutrients from the horse. Certainly, if there's a big population, it can even cause some blockages of the intestine, scarring, and some of the worms, when they migrate through the horse's body, can cause some tissue damage. So the most of the worms that we talk about in the horse, and they're going to lay eggs essentially in the horse's intestinal tract, and they're going to pass out into the manure. So the horse is actually going to get those worms by their eating in the grass, right? And so they're actually going to ingest the larvae that are at the stage that they're capable of infecting the horse. So a lot of it is manure contaminations. So if you want more information on internal parasites and their control in horses, you can visit the SUNUP website.